tonight, we're going to do another big circle dance. Any of you folks standing around out there, get yourself a partner to get in. Keep the partner you've got, unless you want to go get a different, unless you want to get a replacement or take off your jacket or something. Any of you folks over by the door want in, just come on in. Did you lose your partner? Oh, okay, I lost my partner. All right, get yourself a partner and appear in this circle. If you don't have a partner, stand in the middle and somebody will come along and grab you. It doesn't absolutely have to be boy, girl. That's just a little bit better. Anybody else want in? Now, you guys in the back of the corner, this is a risk-free dance. This is one to get in if you want to pile in on this one. All right. All hold hands and form a big circle. Oh, that looks good. Charming. Okay, does everybody have a partner of some sort or other? Say hello to your partner just in case you should have to recognize them in the dark or something. Say hello to your corner. That's the person standing next to you that's not your partner. Now, let me show you what you and your partner are going to do on this one. Promenade position, which means the gent's right hand holds the girl's right hand, the gent's and the right hands are above the left hands. But it doesn't make a whole lot of difference if you do it differently. There we go. That's just standard. That turns out. That's good. They've already figured it out. Okay, walk forward about six steps. One, two, three, four, five, six. Stop right there. Turn and come back. Come back. One, two, three, four, five, six, and stop. Now, the gents step back a little bit and face your partner. The gents' backs will all be in. And the ladies will be facing in. This dance can be a little bit confusing if you don't know your right from your left. So, you can drop your partner's hands now. You can trust you'll find them later in the evening someplace. So, now, everybody locate your right hand, look at your partner, and look at the person to the right of your partner. Point to your right-hand person. You see a right-hand person? You know that face anywhere, right? Okay, good. Do-si-do your partner. Do-si-do your partner.
Yeah.
Now, face that right-hand person. Do-si-do the right-hand person. And come back to your partner. Keep facing your partner now. You about back where you started? Now, believe it or not, there's a left-hand person too. Point to your left-hand person. This is where it gets complicated. Do you know who your left-hand person is? Okay, turn your left-hand person by the left hand once around. Face your partner. Turn your partner by the right hand once around. Back to the left hand person. Turn them by the left once around. Back to your partner with the right hand turn. Back to the left hand person and swing. Stop and promenade position. That's the end of the day.
In case you got confused, you all get a new... Well, our all-star pickup band is ready. Well, promenade. And back the other way. Face your partner and do-si-do.
Do-si-do, the right-hand person. Turn by the left with your left hand around. Partner right. Back to the left with the left-hand person. Turn your partner by the right. Swing that left-hand person around. Swing some more because some folks are lost. Just wait a minute, some folks don't have a partner. Get ready to promenade! Promenade! And back the other way. Do-si-do! Now the right-hand person, do-si-do, on the right you know. Turn by the left with the left-hand person. Partner right with the right hand around, back to the left with the left-hand person. And the partner too. So go and swing that left-hand person. Dominate! Back the other way around. Do-si-do, your partner off. The right-hand person, do-si-do. Turn by the left with your left hand. Partner right. Left hand person. Partner right. Swing your corner. Dominate. And back the other way. Do-si-do, your partner. Right-hand person, do-si-do. Left-hand person with the left-hand around. Back to your partner. Turn by the right. Back to the left with the left-hand around. Back to your partner with the right-hand turn. Swing that left-hand person upside down again. Bombay! And back the other way. Do-si-do, your own pretty girl. And out to the right. Do-si-do, on the right. Over to the left with a left-hand turn. Back to your partner. And out to the left. And back to your partner. Turn by the right with your partner right now. Back to the left with a good old swing. Grab your partner and promenade. The other way. Do-si-do, your own pretty girl. Point to the right. Do-si-do, on the right you know. Out to the left. And around you go. Back to your partner with a right hand turn. And back to the left. One more the partner. Well, swing that corner upside down or around and around. Do-si-do. Promenade around the hall. Back the other way around. Do-si-do, your own sweet gal. Now out to the right. Do-si-do, the one on the right. Over to the left. And turn by the left. With your left hand. Partner right. Turn by the left. Back to your partner with the right hand turn. Swing that corner behind you. The other way around. Do-si-do, your own pretty gal. Out to the right with a do-si-do. The left-hand person with the left-hand around. Partner right. The left-hand person with the left-hand around. Back to your partner with the right-hand turn. And swing her well. Do-si-do, the one you know. Right hand girl. Turn by the left. Partner right. Left hand turn. Partner right. Wait! out to the right, do-si-so. Left hand turn. Partner right. Step in. Partner. Swing your corner around and around. Promenade. Just keep promenading. Promenade straight ahead. Just keep promenading. Bow to your partner, that's all. Stay right there. Now, stay right there.
We weren't torn up. I'd just take you back with me. Stay all night. We can't. I got no place to put anybody now. We're in real state of review.
Are you down with Mona or are you by yourself?
No, I'm Mona's. I'm never by myself. I have no idea. It has been
President Garfield?
2 weeks or 3 weeks since I even picked this up. Too much going on. That's the wrong way to end up life.
I don't know if I...
Well, I don't.
That might be
far away, right? You're just...
I have no idea if I'm standing or not.
I'm off already. I'm quiet. Quiet or sharp? Quiet. Quiet. Hey, have you heard? I'll tell you what you want to hear tonight. They're going to have a jam session somewhere. I don't know where they have it after this. But now they get tired of me asking them to play it. They really have them play that Amelia Walk. Jim,
yeah, I like that a lot.
I watched Kim's second on that. It's just, she's capable of it. It's a B tune, and she's capable of it, so she can do a C. And she walks with her bases down. It really is pretty. That's a pretty walk.
You
don't
be able to do it.
Pretty
well. Where is that from? Do you have any idea?
I've heard it one other place, and I'm trying to think where it was. The only other time I ever heard it was on the radio.
John McCutcheon Band?
No, I don't know.
I've heard that that's where it comes from.
But I've heard it one other time.
And maybe that dulcimer player did it.
Oh, Paul Van Arsdale. You know who I heard play it? I know who it. At this Bethel thing, at the end of it, they had their fiddler's convention up there at Bethel, Missouri. And who's the McCann, that character from St. Louis? Did you ever knew him play the mandolin?
Buchanan. Oh, Buchanan? Little Dennis
crazy.
Or Kurt?
Yeah, Kurt. Kurt? He was with a guy, and they played the best record.
Nice. Must have been Jeff Seitz. Was it Jeff Seitz up there?
Yeah, that's who that was. Blonde-haired boy, and you know.
Curtis is.
Yeah, Kurt's crazy, though. I wish that he should be.
I like Curtis.
He should be institutionalized.
Well, Dennis, he's got a brother, Dennis. And
Dennis is the boy I first met. Dennis, what did Dennis play? Man went all sorts.
Yeah, he plays guitar.
I haven't seen him. His brother married Emily Goodson.
Dennis married.
But Kurt's one was up there.
Yeah, the first time I met those guys, I was still in school. I went up there with Chris German down on the river. Some bar they were playing in.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Wow,
Chris was there last year at Bethel. I hadn't seen him in years. It's
been a long time for me, too. I'd love to go to Bethel.
Played that DJ, that's right. It's on the record.
I think it's on the record.
going to hear. Listen, you'll hear her on that cello. She got a bunch of hornpipes.
Oh, I know. She's a fine violin.
Oh, yeah.
How about a little Shortenin bread?
Okay. It's the same as Irish cobbler. Several stints in it.
Then. Yeah.
And also, Doc Roberts. Where did Brian get it? Yeah. Doc Roberts.
I think he's in the record for you under the Irish cobbler.
Cross to me. Bingo.
Thank you. Thank you.
think those are both of them.
That's what's the twist on it. I've always thought want it to be in D, but it's really. Played the banjo.
I don't know.
Well, whoever played the banjo, whichever one, that's who played it. I've never heard anybody.
Sam plays the banjo.
Is it Sam?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I picked up an old 78. I've been trying to go through, building up quite a collection of 50 cents and a dollar at the most, you know, at these flea markets. And sheet music, any tune I recognize. See, I can't read music, but any tune I recognize is a fiddle tune. I'm getting all this stuff together, and it's all filed with that tune, you know. But I came across an old 78 something McLaughlin and his melody makers, and the tune's called Get Your Foot Out of the Mud. But what's unusual, the first part's a straight hoedown, just the same thing. Then all of a sudden they change keys. They've got a fiddle, a banjo, and a cello. No, oh, we're never playing.
Playing here.
Most of them
pay
50 cents when they come out, see? But they're cheap, I guess. Second part, they go, let's see, it's a D, and then it goes into an A part. But the cello, you're making runs in the background. It's got some minor, a whole bunch of minors in it. It's really an unusual tune. I taped it off to bring to Kim and Jim, and I forgot to bring it to him. I ought to mail you a copy of it. But it's a string band type of thing. The first part isn't much. What makes it interesting is that cello. This guy's just made, in fact, he's doing on the last part, he's making the same runs as the fiddle on that cello.
Really?
Yeah.
I'd be interested to hear it.
I like these cellos. I wish I knew how to play one.
My brother played a cello. My twin brother. That's how I started playing. He and I would just play together.
Boy, you sure heard that Nancy Blake play it. Right? Well, of course, she's got a record out. A lot of them were that, too. And she played some hornpipe on the thing, and it really was good. Something I've got there. A tubberman hornpipe or something like that.
I wouldn't expect a cello and a fiddle to really mesh.
These Germans up in Central Missouri always had a cello in their group. In fact, cello was pretty common in even the string bands originally.
Well, you go back to the roots of most all of this, and it's classical. And
remember that, I mean, that Nadler family or something from up Augusta, Missouri? Did you ever see them? Now, the old man I know is dead now.
No,
the old man played the cello. He was in his 90s when I saw him. And he would sit, and he would chord on it, but then he would do these runs like I'm talking about.
Every second.
Yeah. Of course, I've seen the guy on the bass fiddle do that with a bowl, too. Play a bass fiddle with a bowl in a group and make some runs on the bass, but not loud. I mean, you know, just a real soft. Good bass players are a valuable thing in any group. I don't like electric. They're okay, but I don't like the blue slapping stuff. I like the guy just to.
Oh, yeah. Boy, you can tell a difference.
Oh, yeah.
You haven't run across a 78 by the Massey family doing Varso Vienna.
I've got a sodium, but it's not going to add it. It's some marks for something new.
My mother-in-law's got a bunch of an old fiddler, you know, 78s, bunch of 78s of this guy. One of the good fiddlers. Got Clayton McMitchin, but it's not who I'm thinking of. It's another one she's got that I like. I think he was a good fiddler for his time.
My father-in-law got his family's old record player and all the records, which would be an era from just before the First World War up to say about 1925. And it's really a good cross-section of what they listened to then. There's quite a few Coon records in it. The Preacher and the Bear,
yeah,
type stuff, you know.
Yeah.
But good old tunes are just pretty much a good example of the music of that time. You know. I've been putting all those on cassette. After I finally found the 78 one, now it's good again. I bought it here at Lakey or Pawn Shop. Play something.
Didn't get your hoe cake? Remember how that goes? Didn't get your hoe cake? Is that a B tune?
What happened to that guy that made the fiddle? Ken Sloan bought one time. Oh yeah, he's not there in the folk center anymore.
Monty Abraham?
Yes. No, before Monty Abraham.
Fairfax Abraham.
Yeah, whatever happened to that guy?
I have no idea. Probably in a loony bin somewhere.
No, I don't know.
Did you ever know Fairfax?
Oh yeah.
I just knew, I didn't know him real well.
Oh, I never.
He was kind of controversial.
Kind of AWOL, wasn't he?
He ran the whole gamut of strange things to do. And
I know. The only, have you ever met somebody who knew you got to stay away from? Well, I mean, that's him. Before I ever knew that guy, I knew to stay away from him. I knew there was something.
Though, but he just no direction. But he made it.
Yeah, he bought that. I don't know how much Sloan paid him for that fiddle. And then something went wrong with it, and I don't know if they ever got it straightened out. Play something here.
I'm trying to think how that goes.
I can't remember it. Well, you're thinking, let's do, try this one. You know Old Virginia Reel?
Maybe, yeah. Probably got you playing it.
That's a D tune, isn't it?
Very few records with the first volume. They found him an old wire
recorder because Christmas has got a part broken on it. And as it was, of course, it's really, or he can't remember. And he didn't have, I had the idea he had a whole lot of tapes. And that they were going to pull these off there, but never did find them. He didn't have, in other words, I don't know what it had.
So they never make another?
No, they're not going to. I almost had it. I'll get it here in a minute. Two, he plays one. It's an old church tune. You know, it's almost all in minors. That is.
Am I bound to die?
Yeah, you knew that. That's right.
Oh, that's
my trouble with those, I try to put too much in them. When his brother seconds it, he just goes pretty straight on the thing. It sounds real good. Boy, it's a beautiful music. I went to, only about to go one time, and it was just too fast. I'm going to find out. I went to Church of Christ up at Bolivar last night to a singing school for shape notes. And
for what?
Singing school for shape notes. And the boy, a young girl about your age, nice looking, beautiful tenor voice, went to Hardy, Arkansas. And the only thing was, what this was he was showing their choir what what Signal was. Well, they all read music and they already knew their hymns. There they didn't care. There's one old boy there in his overalls. Me, we were lost completely. But I learned a lot that one night, a whole lot of it. But he was talking above me. I need to get in with a bunch of first graders. But there used to be an old boy and his family that had a little non-denominational, probably really offshoot Pentecostal or Baptist of some kind, between Ozark and Ava on 14 Highway, a little area called Dogwood. And they were teaching shape note. In other words, they're using not a revival thing, just they always have, you know. That's interesting. You know, have you ever been around shape note?
I'll tell you where it was first, and that's first family reunion I went to of Melissa's. Her grandpa grew up in church of Christ.
Yeah.
Grandpa Rowd is gone now.
Yeah.
Let everybody in shape notes.
They sing their songs in shape notes, and then they'd sing them, you know. I really do. They were just too advanced for me, and I wanted to find a little more basic things to get with.
Now, there's people that take it real serious now. So.
Oh, yeah. They had a Sacred Harp convention in St. Louis a few months ago. I'd like to. Have you ever heard that Sacred Harp singing?
Yeah.
That's unusual stuff, you know.
It's
interesting.
It's real
minor-y.
Really,
oh, yeah, and no instrumental music at all, you know. It's all apathetic. You got that, too?
I think so.
It's chilly out here.
Do you remember it all?
Yeah.
Supposedly one of the best fiddlers in that area. That's what they, that's what I've done. But it's incredible that picture. Every one of those guys played fiddle. Thank you.
put this on the window? Where is this building down there? Do you know where that is?
I think I can find it again.
I think it'll be the only thing showing for any people around.
It's, as you go back through town, it's on your right.
Okay.
And maybe around the sharp turn.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Okay, I know where. I think I know where it is. I may stop.
I think it's where.
I've heard people play it different too, but...
Stuff put together here.